Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is discussing the conversation that took place between the Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam and his brothers when they came to know, or they realized, or it dawned upon them that the person sitting in front of them with authority could be their brother. So they said, قَالُوا أَإِنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ يُوسُف. Now in terms of in Balagha, this is known as Inkari. The Kalam is brought in Inkari form, meaning when the person is saying something and he wants to emphasize it because he's unsure, he wants to make a, so they want to emphasize the question. They were just shocked and mesmerized and just they couldn't believe it, that the person in front of them could be Yusuf. So because they were munkir, so when they say munkir, it's not really, it doesn't have to be always a literal term of those who reject, but munkir is a term in this balagha that it means that they were very, very uncertain and they just couldn't believe it. So you have it's istifham. Inna, sarfu mushabbihun bil fa'l for emphasis. You have lam al muzahlaqa, also known as lam al tawkid, second emphasis. And then anta is zamir al fasl. So it creates three emphasis. Innaka la anta Yusuf. They were so, just couldn't believe that that person could be their brother who they had thrown in the well decades ago. That's quite simple. Then the next question is, okay, if the questioners were asking a question and they were dubious and they were almost, they were munkir, meaning they couldn't believe it, then the reply should also have some form of emphasis. But if you look at the emphasis, if you look at the reply of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, there's no emphasis at all. It just says here, Ana Yusuf wa hadha akhi. So then why, so the general rule is, if the su'al has a form of emphasis, then the reply should also have a form of emphasis. The answer to that could be, that you can't see emotions. Obviously, emotions are displayed on the face, voice, tone of the voice, the loudness of the voice. So it's very possible that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so even though they are munkir and they're ta'keeding their question, Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, he did not, when he was, if you picture it, you go into Wonderland, you start imagining this, he wasn't gloating. Now look, see, I am Yusuf. Yeah, look what happened. Look what you done to me. He was very humble. And he realized only the fadl of Allah, the ni'mah of Allah. So he was very, so his tone was very, very of the humility. So by removing, so even though the maqam requires ta'keed from our logic perspective, like if it's ta'keed here, the answer should also have emphasis. So it's very possible Allah removed all emphasis in here to depict and for us to think and ponder upon the emotional state or how the tone of his voice. It wasn't of any emphasis. Maybe he did emphasize it, but there was no emotion or no tone or no implication in his voice or in his actions or in his words, which was gloating. So by removing all ta'keed, that element has been removed. So yes, innaka la anta Yusuf, the question has ta'keed, so the reply should also have ta'keed. But the ta'keed has been removed to remove the show or to for us to think about his tone of his voice. It was full of humility and of arrogance. If la ana Yusuf, it doesn't have to automatically imply there was arrogance to it, but by not having any emphasis at all, it creates and shows us that his tone is very, very humble. Wallahu subhanahu wa ta'ala alam wa ilmuhu atam.